Hi folks, I'm Chris and I'm your Commander Mechanic, here with a special video. Our friends over at the Mind Sculptors asked us to participate in their Iconic Decklist Challenge, and I can't refuse a challenge. They asked us to adapt an archetype from Magic history to EDH, an exercise aimed at seeing how a deck from a 60-card format can translate into a 100-card singleton format. Naturally, I leapt at the opportunity. The archetype I'm taking a swing at is AFFINITY. This classic archetype was born from Mirrodin Block Standard, but has persisted in Modern for years. This has given me quite a bit to pull from, and dozens of lists to play with. But it appears the Standard and Modern lists play very differently. The Standard Era AFFINITY list was an interesting aggro/aristocrats build. Taking advantage of the artifact lands and cheap artifact creatures, this deck could very quickly have 4, 5, or 6 artifacts in play. It would then take advantage of the deck's namesake mechanic, AFFINITY, to help reduce the costs of their permanents and spells. Spells like Thoughtcast, Frogmite, and Mirror Enforcer were mainstays of this era. Creatures that could be free, or draw spells that were heavily discounted. But the big punch this deck packed was around cranial plating, an equipment, which was new to Magic at the time, that gives a creature +1/+0 for each artifact you control, with an equip cost of just 1 mana, or being able to be moved at instant speed with double black, it was difficult to be able to block all of the AFFINITY player's creatures without knowing which one would punch you right in the face. This deck also has very potent aristocrat lines thanks to sac outlets like Atog and Arcbound Ravager. Combined with Disciple of the Vault, which deals damage to opponents whenever an artifact is put into the graveyard from the battlefield, this was a great fallback win con to do the last few points of damage. With these two strategies in the deck, you could easily punch in for 8-10 with cranial plating, then sacrifice the rest of your artifacts after damage to ping down your opponent. This became so oppressive in Standard that this deck alone got Artifact Lands and Disciple of the Vault banned in Standard. And we'll find out that's not where the bans end for AFFINITY. Modern AFFINITY is a similar beast, however, outgrew the use of any actual AFFINITY cards. The namesake is a holdover to the Standard era, but you'll find quite a bit of overlap between Standard and Modern builds. Modern AFFINITY makes the use of zero casting cost artifacts like Memnite and Ornithopter to quickly establish Metalcraft. That helps you use additional mana generators like Mox Opal, another card that would soon be banned thanks to AFFINITY's exploits. Using this fast mana, small creatures, and big board states, AFFINITY staples Artifact Ravager, Cranial Plating, and Blinkmoth Nexus could become very dangerous very fast. Additional evasive creatures like Vault Scourge or Signal Pest made these smaller creatures even more valuable, but Steel Overseer started to make them dangerous. This deck even includes Inkmoth Nexus, which, combined with Cranial Plating, or counters from Arcbound Ravager, could spell an infect win out of nowhere. So with these two iterations on the AFFINITY archetype in mind, where do we start with adapting it to high power Commander? First, I wanted to start with our Commander choices. AFFINITY, traditionally, is, well, very light on colors. Looking at the variations, they have black for Disciple of the Vault and blue for Thoughtcast, maybe. It's a pretty open field. But I know for certain I want to use Silas Renn, Seeker Adept, in the command zone. Not only is he naturally an artifact himself, but he can allow us to cast more artifacts from the graveyard when he connects for damage. Perfect. Everything we want to do. His partner should allow us access to at least one other color, so I decided to pair him with Tymna the Weaver. We get white for some specific artifact-based strategies, and we can take advantage of Tymna's card drawing capabilities. Previous iterations of AFFINITY have some common threads and some distinctly disparate goals. Standard AFFINITY was an aristocrat-style deck. Modern AFFINITY is largely aggro. And artifacts in these colors lean us toward combo in Commander. So let's see if we can wrap all of that together. The list will be very artifact heavy, naturally, so let's use that to power creatures, combos, and aggressive wins. This can make us a very versatile deck that pivots based on what the table is doing in order to take advantage of other players' board states. Our aggro strategy can be fueled by cranial plating and a volume of artifacts. This card alone can turn a Blink Moth Nexus or an Ornithopter into a massive threat that demands to be dealt with. Our other creatures in the deck can lend to this as well. I've included staples like Arcbound Ravager, Arcbound Worker, Frogmite, and Mirror Enforcer. Our Aristocrats line naturally hinges on Disciple of the Vault, with our artifacts either sacrificing themselves inherently with their own abilities, or with an Arcbound Ravager for the most classic-feeling affinity win. And our combo lines are numerous, naturally. We have infinite mana combos with Power Artifact to be able to win with Staff of Domination or Walking Ballista. Rings of Bright Hearth works with Basalt Monolith or Grim Monolith along these same lines, generating us infinite colorless mana to pump into our win cons. And we have the uniquely commander combo of Shroom the Hegemon plus an artifact that clones, either Phyrexian Metamorph or Sculpting Steel. This combo nets us a tidy little loop for infinite enters the battlefield and dies triggers. Paired with Disciple of the Vault, we have a three-card combo using the graveyard that can win us the game on the spot. Apart from these strategy mainstays, the deck is populated with small utility and mana artifacts, not unlike traditional modern affinity lists, as well as control and card draw elements. Classic high-power staples like Mana Crypt and Mana Vault, Force of Will, Black's Tutors, Blue's Artifact Tutors, and a Break in Case of Glass emergency line of Demonic Consultation and Thassa's Oracle. Notably here, because we're using the artifact lands, we can include Tainted Pact as a redundant copy of Demonic Consultation, since no two cards in the deck share a name. Overall, the deck definitely has the hallmark of a high-power list. Instant win combos, high-value floors, and massive threat levels. But it also bears the charm of affinity decks from their respective formats. Fast artifacts, vomiting your hand onto the battlefield, and shockingly quick wins. If you're considering something like this, just beware. Null Rod or Collector Oof just plain shut you down, so have some interaction for them. Let me know what you think of this list in the comments below, and be sure to check out the rest of the Iconic Decklist Challenge from other content creators as well. As always, folks, thanks for tuning in, good luck, and have fun.